Hello and welcome. My name is Manuel Quintana with Pragmatic Works, and in collaboration with MAQ Software, we're bringing you today's video to look at their fantastic custom visual known as the calendar visual. This is an extremely super effective way to manage your events inside of Power BI, giving up a plethora of features, month view, day view, week view, seeing your events as items, doing some groupings on categories, really a lot of functionality to make this a very interactive calendar, making it easy for everyone to use. Let's take a look at it in Power BI. So here we are looking at the calendar visual by MAQ Software. And as we can see, I have the visual currently selected with some data populated in there. And as far as for fields that are available to be mapped, we have four options. We have the start date, end date, events, and event group. Now, the only mandatory fields are the start date and the events. Other than that, it's not necessary, but we can add in end date as well as event groups and potentially some additional tooltips, which is extremely beneficial in this type of visual to make it that much more easy to view and read. For the start and the end dates, it's important to note that these must be in date time formats and the events should be in your text data type. So the start and the end date, as you'd expect, they represent the start and the end date times of events so we can have multiple items represented within the same day. We'll see as we move through the views, this can become very critical. The event group, which we know is optional, allows us to categorize the events into groups based on the value and gives groups of events same colors. So as we can see in this current state, we're looking right now at various different events, but we actually haven't actually grouped it itself. So if we can look, we have start, end date, events. If we want to though, just by dragging in event groups, we can see that now all these individual events will fall under their respective categories and they all get colored the same. So we still see the same items within the calendar itself, as we can see, it's just different colorations because they're being grouped together in their respective categories. So once again, it is optional, but it can add some nice continuity to this. Looking very quickly, just by clicking the respective dialog, we can see week, day, and then we can go all the way down to a list representation of the events that are occurring. And notice we also, of course, have a toggle box here where we can go by month to month to month. If we just click today, it'll use our system time and find today's date. As we can see when we go in the month as well as the specific week, it highlights specifically we're working on January 8th here, this Tuesday in 2019, but you can see it illustrates this. So there's a lot of really nice functionality and features, and we can see how we can very much control this experience for our users in the format area. So let's go over there and take a look at that now. The first option we can see is we have control over our legend. And in here, of course, it's the standard items we would come to know and expect, the positioning, if we would like this on the top or the bottom, the coloration, as well as the text size, which is important. Also, we have the capability of changing the colors for each of our events. Now, because in this case, we have added an event group, this makes it a smaller list. If I were to have removed this, we can see that our data colors gets a little more invested and involved. That's where those event groups, that level of categorization, can be extremely beneficial. But regardless of what level of granularity you choose, you do have complete control over what color represents the events themselves. Now here, under the events section, users can change the font color and border coloring for our respective events. So if we wanted to change something and make it maybe black stand out a little bit more, we can absolutely do that if we so choose. And that bordering color, as you'd expect, it's going to be affecting the outside of the area itself. So you can add things here just to make it a little more impactful, maybe more stand out. If there's any sort of theme that relates to the company, you could leverage that here too. Inside of the views area, this will allow us to specify how users can navigate between the various levels of detail. Do we want to allow the week view? Do we want to allow the day view? Or in the list, we can turn this on or off. The month by default is always on and is the primary viewing experience. And we can control at what levels and what degrees our users should have access to here within this view tab. The next item for work hours, we can specify the actual work hours for our days in question. As you can see here, we have this listed as 9 to 5. So it'll show nice and white. Everything else gets this low lighted, kind of this blue representation. So we can very much easily identify items and events that fall within our business hours, within our work hours, and those that fall outside of them. Also, we can specify which days of the week actually are part of the work week simply by toggling this on and off. As we see here, Sunday is not a work day, but maybe now it is, and you can see it opens up and it follows the rules that we have set for the work hours. Underneath that, we have the option for our calendar settings with quite a few elements. What do we want our work week to start on? Here, I'm in Florida, pretty standard to start with Sunday, but depending on where you are in the world, it might be more traditional to have it start with Saturday, or even Monday itself is somewhat more traditional in other areas. So you can dictate exactly how this should be represented, how it should be viewed. We also have the capability of showing our current time. As we can see, the time of this recording is represented by this red line. So by turning this off, it goes away. By turning it on, it is presented there. So in the month, of course, we don't have the level of detail, the granularity down to the hour, but definitely during the week, we can see that as well. And definitely during the day view, also we can have this access. In that list element, we can see that I have it just here, but because it's just listing out our events, we don't have the granularity of individual times. The navigation link is really fantastic and it allows users to navigate between week and day view just by clicking on the specific actual date. So we can see I have this turned on, and if we turn back to month, I can actually go here and I can click on a couple of choices actually. We can go ahead and click here if I'm interested in, let's click today. No, let's click the second, which has three events. I just click on the number. I have now drilled down into that day view of that item right here. Really fantastic. Also, we have this option when we enable the week numbers, if we turn this on, we can actually click on the specific week itself and it goes down to that week view. So it's simply just another way of navigating rather than using these dialog boxes here in the upper right corner. The last item that we have specific to this visual available to us is to enable this right to left layout. And as you'll see right away, and this is going to be specific to every view, we're effectively reversing this order. So we have Sunday through Saturday, but from right to left. Looking at the week, same item, the day, it's just the time is going to be represented on the right-hand side. So just changing the orientation. So a lot of fantastic features available in this calendar visual by MAQ Software. And thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions about this visual or need a similar business solution, feel free to contact MAQ Software at sales@maqsoftware.com. As well, for any of your Power BI training needs, be sure to reach out to us at Pragmatic Works by emailing training@pragmaticworks.com. Take care.